Yo, what's up? It's Oliver Helmers here, and I've got the honor to do an official remix for legendary Another Chance by Roger Sanchez for its 20-year anniversary. And today I'm going to show you what I'm going for. I'm going to show you what I have so far. So let's have a look. So as you can see, I work in Fruity Loops, FL Studio. And for the remix, I went for something a little bit more progressive. It personally reminds me a bit of Camel Fat's style and people like Frankie Wah or like the Anjuna Deep label. But it still has a lot of energy and it's suitable for the main stage. Let's have a listen. It's not finished yet though. I'm still working on it, but the main idea is definitely there. So this is just still the intro with like a typical 1/16th sequencer bass, and here of course we hear the original vocals from Toto. And here the sequencer bass comes back in slowly. And I added some synth pads. Here we go. Yes, some nice arps. I love those arps. Into the second break with that that iconic piano. Here the pets come back in. Where are you? Of course, the pads from the Roger Sanchez version. And here we go again. Modulation on those arps. Vocals back in again. Still a lot of elements from the original as well. So, yeah, I guess, yeah, I should show you some more inside here. Yeah, so let's have a closer look at those ARPs and the bass, the sequencer bass. So I guess those are kind of the main elements for this remix. Yeah, so let's have a look at the bass first. So yeah, this is how the drop sounds again. Yeah, so here we have the bass. It's several layers. But this is kind of the main layer. Oh, it's loading. Yeah, so I got the sound out of the VPS Avenger synth. So this is like a one octave higher, kind of lighter lead, lower in volume, and this is kind of the main lead. This one. So yeah, let's have a look at the MIDI. So as you can see, it's all like 1/16th notes, but there's still some movement going on, and some, it's somehow still kind of funky, because it goes up one octave in like a, you know, like a swingy rhythm. Like that. I guess maybe I should just slow it down a lot, so then it's easier to hear what's going on. Yeah. So yeah, this kind of forms, yeah, like the basics, yeah, of the foundation of the remix, and then this is the sub, and there's more layers. I did add a little bit of a how you say that, like a 303 layer, but it's very subtle, but it definitely adds something. It's barely hearable though. Oh yeah, there's another layer, and then we have big fat sub, like you're used from me. And the big sub I did in silent. Yeah, so this is how the sub looks like. Yeah, it goes to a sidechain now. Also, yeah, the sub sidechains a little bit more heavily than this guy. It goes over here in a shaper box. I really like the shaper box for sidechaining nowadays. Because for example, in this synth, I split up the low and the mid for the sidechaining, and the mid gets a lighter sidechain than the low end, because for the mid and the high, you only really want to sidechain the top, the attack, the punch, the kick. But for the low end, you also want a little bit of the tail sidechained. Also, as you can see here, it's 100%. The sidechain is on 100%. It kills the volume 100%. But for the mid zone, it's 86%. Yeah, I guess. that's that sorts out the base. Alright, but before I go too much in depth on the bass, let's have a look at the arpeggios. I really like those arpeggios. And yeah, they're really catchy. They go nicely together with the bass. Let's check out the main layer. I mean, yeah, like the main sound from Nexus. The Deep House 2 synths, LFO Sols. Yeah, so here's the lead melody. So yeah, what's happening in this is that yeah, just got those notes at the top, they kind of stay the same, and I guess they are kind of like the main melody. Well, the other notes, which are more, you know, like the real arpeggio notes, they follow the chord that's playing. So. And you know, like here in the third and fourth bar, there are some nice variations. Do I have more variations? No, that was it. But then what I like to do with when I have a melody like this is to add a harmony. So here's the harmony. So it plays different notes, but it sounds really well together with the main lead. And as you can hear, it's, you know, like much lower in the mix, because it's just really a harmony. Yeah. But it makes the melody sound much more rich, I guess. I don't really use any musical theory for this. I just kind of I just click those in by ear. At this point, I've made so many melodies in my life. Usually also I don't really use my keyboard. I just make them in my mind and then I click them in. Nowadays when I do those harmony melodies, I can already hear them in my head and just click them in, and it works out pretty well for me. So that's what I did for those arps. And then there's some extra layers. Let me check what's this. Oh yeah. You're like a nice little plucky sound. Not that interesting on its own. It's just like a nice layer. Also, yeah, comes out of that VPS Avenger synth. Which I really like nowadays. And the arp starts out a little bit in a filter. And there's a bunch of automation going on. Like here, it opens up the filters. And here's a nice little extra layer that gets added. Like an organ sound. Also from a VPS Avenger. And also in this organ sound, It has like a harmony layer. Mm-hmm. Also, something you may notice if you're very familiar with the Roberto Sanchez, his version, then I did something different with the chords. Because, you know, here is Roberto Sanchez. So here, this second long chord kind of stays the same. But I wanted to follow the chords from the from the original Toto version. Here you hear like the piano in the background, which does it. So here in my pads. So they have the same, you know, the same movement that Roger Sanchez added in his version, but I still wanted to go to a different chord for the second long chord, which makes it a little bit more emotional, I guess. And throughout the break, there's a little bit of development going on, like some extra notes here at the top. Here. Yeah, it cuts off here right now, but then in the second break, I have it play through. I still need to improve the mix a lot. I'm not happy yet with the mix, but so this is kind of the main idea that I have for the remix now. I'm really excited about this. So yeah, it's been a big pleasure to work on this remix, and a big honor. Yeah, I'm a big fan of the original from Roger Sanchez. It's definitely one of my favorites from that early 2000s era. And yeah, maybe even one of my favorite house records of all time. So I hope I did it justice. I think I did so. So yeah, I hope you like it as well. I'll spend some more time on getting the mix right and getting the sound better. But yes, enjoy. Yo.